Hey guys, welcome to another video brought to you by me, Adam from Beautiful Life Hypnotherapy. Hope you're all well. This week I'm discussing why diets don't work and, controversially, why diet clubs don't work. Now, what makes me say that? Well, it's actually their own figures. If you look at them, I think there's an 11% success rate. And also, a famous CEO of one of these diet clubs turned around publicly and said, well, the business is built on people's failures. So they expect people to fail. So they come back time and time again, signing up, paying their money, only to fail again. Plus, another reason is I don't particularly like their idea of the humiliation they cause people every week by putting them on the scales in front of everybody. What a great idea. Nat. How ridiculous and humiliating for the people who are paying good money to be at those clubs to be paraded in front of their peers, their friends, and humiliated by everyone knowing whether they've gained or lost or stayed the same weight. I know a few of the people who have ran these clubs over the years, and let me tell you, they're not the slimmest people either. So what does that tell you? If you go to a weight management or weight diet club, and frankly the person's overweight, what does that tell you? That tells you that they don't listen to their own advice and can't even do what they're preaching. So they don't really do anything to do with mindset. Now, I don't give my clients nutritional advice. I'm not a nutritionist, but I know there's enough information out there, good information out there, to plan your own healthy diet. Now, my job is to help your mindset get around the idea of eating healthy. This is something the clubs don't do very well. They don't take into account, for example, desensitization. So, when somebody starts to reduce in weight, lose weight, say they get down to, say they were, I don't know, 17 stone, they get down to 15. Say they go off the wagon and they start to gain weight again, the mind will not notice the 17 stone. It's not until they get to about 17 and a half, 18, the mind suddenly goes, oh dear, I've put a bit of weight on here, better do something about it again. Lose the weight again, fall off the wagon, put the weight back on. But it's not going to notice the 17 stone, is it? Maybe not the 17 and a half, maybe not even 18. It's only as they get to like 18 and a half that the mind starts to notice. This is something that they don't take into consideration, the desensitization of weight that people seem to go through. So this is why things like the clubs and traditional diets tend to not work very well, because the mindset hasn't been taken care of. And you know, if you're doing it as a lot of people don't enjoy it, so that it's seen as a punishment, then we don't really do anything in life, do we? If it's a punishment, we sort of go along with it, but our heart's not in it. What I recommend for a weight management are some simple, easy guidelines to follow. So I recommend that you eat when you're hungry. Now, the reason for this is the body's asking for fuel. This is when you have to put the correct fuel in. Because if you don't put the right fuel in, you're not going to get the right result out. So it's a bit like a car, using the metaphor. If you put the wrong fuel in, it's not going to run properly. Your mind and the body is the same. The 80-20 rule is eat 80% healthy, 20% a little bit of what you like. Now, you can do this on a daily basis or a weekly basis. Therefore, you are not depriving yourself of that treat, that snack, that little bit of a thing you may like. So when you don't deprive yourself of something that you like, you don't crave it. Hence why it's important to have that treat. So eat what you want, as long as it's 80% healthy, and then that 20% little bit of a snack, you know, Saturday night, curry, few beers, whatever you like. Also, take a little bit more time over your food. So chew a little bit more, put your knife and fork down between mouthfuls. Don't have any distractions on at all, like TVs, phones, whatever you might have. If you can eat at the table, that's brilliant. So distractions are exactly that. They distract the mind. So when we distract the mind when we're eating, say we're looking on Facebook, like you probably are watching this video now, or watching YouTube, or watching the news, or soap, what happens is the signal from the stomach to the brain gets dulled. So your stomach is saying, I'm getting full, but we don't actually hear that signal. The brain doesn't register it because it's concentrating on something else. So that's why it's important to have nothing on when we're eating and just try and eat in silence and enjoy the tastes, enjoy the textures. Really start to notice what you like about the food, because the more you can enjoy eating those healthy foods, again, the more of less of a task it's going to become. So it's really important to be almost mindfulness when you eat. So, and chew quite a lot. So there are my tips and tricks for you, which is eat when you're hungry, eat the correct foods. Have 80% healthy and 20% a little bit of what you like. And make sure you have no distractions and try to eat a little bit more mindfully, chewing more, putting your knife and fork down, etc. And what you'll find is it becomes a lot easier. Now, when something becomes easier, we tend to carry on with it. So then we start to maintain it. So I use the word weight management because we manage our weight, don't we? We manage our weight whether we do it well, average, or poor. So what we want to start to do, because if we lose something, we tend to want to find it. So psychologically, weight loss isn't the best term. Some people agree with it, some people disagree with it and say it's a load of old rubbish that we lose. Try to find things that we've lost. But I use the word management because I think it's a better use of words and a better terminology for me personally. It may not be for everybody. So I hope this has helped, guys. And if you have any questions or require any help with your weight management, just give me a shout. You can go to the website, which is BL Hypnotherapy, or you can message me here on Facebook or drop me an email. Thanks for listening, guys. Take care. This is Adam from Beautiful Life Hypnotherapy.